Hello and welcome to another episode of Today's GK. I am Pooja Dwivedi, and in this segment we bring to you objective questions on a daily basis to help you crack prelims. So let's begin with the practice question of last segment. Consider the following statements with reference to genetically modified crops. First, in India, the Genetic Engineering Appraisal Committee is the apex body that allows for commercial release of GM crops. Second, BT cotton and BT paddy, the only GM crops that are allowed in India. Third, use of the unapproved GM variant can attract a jail term of 5 years. Under the Environmental Protection Act of 1986, let's move on to our options, which say which of the statements given above is or are correct. A1 and 2 only, B2 and 3 only, C1 and 3 only, or D1, 2 and 3. The correct answer for this question is, let's see the statements once again. Now the correct answer for this question is C, that is 1 and 3 only. Only the first and the third statements are correct. So let's move on to the explanation. Genetic engineering aims to transcend the genus barrier by introducing an alien gene in the seeds to get the desired effect. That desired effect could be, say, a safe from any kind of pest or infestations, or even to increase the nutrient content. The alien gene could be from a plant, an animal, or even a soil bacterium. If we talk about India, GM cotton, BT cotton, is the only GM crop that is allowed in India, and it has two alien genes from the soil bacterium Bacillus thuringiensis. Now that allows the crops to develop a protein toxic. This protein is toxic to the common pest pink bollworm. Alright? Also, in India, the Genetic Engineering Appraisal Committee is the apex body that allows for the commercial release of GM crops. And in 2002 only, the GEAC had allowed the commercial release of BT cotton. Now, more than 95% of the country's cotton's area has since then come under the BT cotton acreage. Use of unapproved GM variant can invite a jail term of 5 years and a fine up to 1 lakh rupees, a fine of, not up to, of 1 lakh rupees under the Environmental Protection Act of 1986. So let's move on to the first question of today's segment. Consider the following statements about artificial sun. First, it is a nuclear fusion reactor. Second, it uses a powerful magnetic field to fuse hot plasma. Which of the statements given above is or are correct? A1 only, B2 only, C both 1 and 2, D neither 1 nor 2. The correct answer for this question is C, that is both 1 and 2. Let's move on to the explanation. Now, China has successfully powered up its artificial sun nuclear fusion reactor for the first time. It is named as the HL2M Tokamak reactor, and it's China's largest and most advanced nuclear fusion experimental research device, and scientists have hoped that this could potentially unlock a powerful clean energy source, and we need that because a UNEP report has recently suggested that in the year 2030, the world is going to double its production of coal, oil and gas. So we need a clean energy source. So it uses a powerful magnetic field to fuse hot plasma and can reach temperatures of over 150 million degree Celsius as well. So it is located in the southwestern Sichuan province of China, and it is being called an artificial sun on account of the enormous heat it is going to produce. Fusion is considered as the holy grail of energy because this is what powers the sun. Alright, moving on, let's talk about our next question. The Arecibo Observatory, recently seen in the news, is located in which of the following countries? A. Mexico, B. Dominica, C. Guyana, or D. Puerto Rico. The correct answer for this question is D, that is Puerto Rico. So, why is this in news? Because Puerto Rico, massive Arecibo telescope has collapsed, and it was famous for its stellar contribution in the field of astronomy. The collapse was devastating, as for many Puerto Ricans, it was not just a telescope but also a culturally significant phenomenon, right? So the US National Science Foundation was owning this telescope, and the second largest dish radio telescope in the world. Arecibo had withstood many hurricanes and earthquakes since the year 1963. So, this telescope was not only just popularized by the scientific community but also by the Hollywood industry. How? It was featured in the 1999 film James Bond by the name of GoldenEye, and also Jodie Foster's 1997 film Contact. Alright, moving on. Let's talk about the next question, which says, with reference to cannabis, consider the following statements. First, most species of cannabis are dioecious plants that can be identified as either male or female. The major psychoactive constituent in cannabis is delta-9 tetrahydrocannabinol. Now you have to tell me which of the statements given above is or are correct. A1 only, B2 only, C both 1 and 2, D neither 1 nor 2. The correct answer for this question is C, that is both 1 and 2, both of these statements are correct. Moving on to the explanation. The United Nations Commission on Narcotic Drugs on Wednesday has voted to remove cannabis and cannabis resin from Schedule 4 of the 1961 Single Convention on Narcotic Drugs. So it has removed, it has voted to remove it. So CND has chosen to affirm a World Health Organization recommendation from 2019 to remove cannabis from its most dangerous category, with 27 member states who voted in favor, 25 voted against it, and one was in abstention. So according to the WHO, cannabis is a generic term, alright, and it is used to denote several psychoactive preparations from the plant cannabis sativa, and the Mexican name marijuana is frequently used in referring to cannabis. So it not only includes cannabis leaves but also other crude plants, crude plant materials in many other countries. Most species of cannabis are dioecious, that means they can be identified as either male or female plants, and the unpollinated female plants are known as hashish. The major psychoactive constituent in cannabis is delta-9 tetrahydrocannabinol, right? That is why the statements were correct. Let's move on to the next question. The term concussion substitute recently seen in the news is related to which of the following sports? A. Football, B. Cricket, C. Volleyball, D. Basketball. The correct answer for this question is cricket. That is the option B. Let's move on to the explanation. So, controversy has erupted for the first time during India's ongoing tour of Australia, where Yuzvendra Chahal, he came in as a concussion substitute for Ravindra Jadeja in the opening T20 and ended up being the player of the match after he took 3 wickets. The Australian team management disagreed with this, and the referee of the match, that was David Boons, he decided to allow an Indian concussion sub despite Jadeja not being given a concussion test, because concussion test is necessary on the spot. So that decision was disagreed for. And the International Cricket Council concussion management, it, the guidelines which provides, it allows concussion test at the end of the over as well as all the end of the over if the player resumes play after having sustained a blow on the head. In this case, the end of the over, it marked the end of the innings, and Jadeja was assessed after he returned from the return to the dressing room. Now let's look at the next question. With reference to lab grown or cultured meat, consider the following statements. First, it is grown directly from cells in a laboratory. Second, it comes directly from animals. Now, which of the statements given above is or are correct? A1 only, B2 only, C both 1 and 2, D neither 1 nor 2. The correct answer for this question is A, that is 1 only. Let's move on to the explanation. Now, the Singapore Food Agency approved this week the sale of a lab cultured meat product. And this is for the first time cultured meat has been cleared for sale anywhere in the world. So, you have to remember the name Singapore Food Agency for this. Alright. So, the product approved by the SFA is cultured chicken and it is produced by US-based Eat Just. The company has announced the product will be manufactured with local partnership under its brand name of Good Meat. Alright, and cultured meat is grown directly from cells in a laboratory. It's very different from conventional meat in this sense. It offers alternatives to traditional meat products that could feed a lot of many more people and reduce the threat of zoonotic disease. Now, what are zoonotic disease? Diseases that get transferred from animals to humans are known as zoonotic disease, and mitigate the environmental impacts of meat consumption as well. So, in terms of cellular structure, cultured or cultivated meat is the same as the conventional meat, except that cultured meat does not come directly from animals. Let's move on to our next question. The state of the global climate report is being published by which of the following organizations? A. World Meteorological Organization, B. World Bank, C. United Nations Environment Program, or D. World Economic Forum. The correct answer for this question is A, that is World Meteorological Organization. So climate change continued its relentless march in 2020, which is on the track to become one of the three warmest years on record. So the decade of, which is known as the warmest decade on record, is from 2011 to 2020, with the warmest 6 years being since 2015, according to the World Meteorological Organization provisioned report on the state of the global climate in the year 2020. Now, ocean heat is at a record level, and more than 80% of the global ocean experienced a marine heat wave at some time in 2020, with widespread repercussions from marine ecosystem already suffering from a more acidic. Why it is becoming more acidic? Because it is acting as a sink, carbon dioxide sink. This is the reason, because it is absorbing carbon dioxide and then only it is becoming acidic. The report, which is based on the contribution of dozens of international organizations and experts, shows how high impact events, including extreme heat, wildfires and floods, as well as record-breaking Atlantic hurricane season, is affecting millions of people and compounding threats to human health and security and economic stability post-COVID era. Because COVID is already posing threat to the entire mankind, now that's also accelerating because of climate change. So, despite the COVID-19 lockdown, atmospheric concentrations of greenhouse gases, they continue to rise, committing the planet to further warming for many generations to come because of a lifelong time of CO2 in the atmosphere, along with other greenhouse gases like methane, nitrogen dioxide. So many gases, greenhouse gases are there, which are contributing to GHG effect. Now let's move on to the next question. Which of the following is our constituent organisms of corals? Algae, fungi or fungi, bryophytes. Select the correct answer using code given below. 1 and 2 only, 1 only, 2 and 3 only, 1, 2 and 3. The correct answer for this question is B, that is 1 only. Let's move on to the explanation. The corals are made up of genetically identical organisms which are known as polyps. So, the polyps have microscopic algae with the name of zooxanthellae. Now, these live within their tissue, the tissues of the corals. And these have mutualistic relationship, that means they are beneficial to each other's existence. So, the coral provides the zooxanthellae with the compounds necessary to photosynthesis. And in return, the zooxanthellae supply the corals with organic products of photosynthesis, like carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are utilized by the coral polyps for synthesis for their calcium carbonate skeleton. And in addition to providing corals with essential nutrients, zooxanthellae are responsible for unique and beautiful colors of corals. So it may be asked in prelims which of the following elements are responsible for colors of the corals. So you can answer it as zooxanthellae. They are also called rainforest of the sea corals. Alright, and there are two types of corals. First is the stony shallow water corals, the kind that builds the reefs, and soft corals, and deep water corals, they live in dark, cold waters. Now let's move on to the next question. Which of the following states shares a boundary with Myanmar? First, Arunachal Pradesh. Second, Nagaland. Third, Manipur. Fourth, Mizoram. Now select the correct answer using code given below. A1 and 2 only, B2 and 3 only, C1, 3 and 4 only, or D1, 2, 3 and 4. The correct answer for this question is D, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, all of these states. Myanmar, it shares a long land border with India of over 1600 kilometers as a maritime boundary in the Bay of Bengal. And if we talk about the states, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur and Mizoram are the states which share an international boundary with Myanmar. And both the countries, they share a rich common heritage of religion, linguistic and ethnic in nature. And Myanmar has a substantial population of Indian origin, which is estimated to be 1.5 to 2 million. So further, Myanmar is our gateway, very important to us because it is our gateway to the Southeast Asia and ASEAN, with which we are seeking greater economic integration through India's Look East and Act East policy. Myanmar also offers us an alternative access route to the Northeast, and very important now because of tense ties with China as well. Now let's look at the next question. With reference to non-banking financial company, consider the following statements. First, NBFC can accept demand deposit. Second, NBFCs do not form part of the payment and settlement system and cannot issue checks drawn on itself. Now, which of the statements given above is our correct? A1 only, B2 only, C both 1 and 2, D neither 1 nor 2. The correct answer for this question is B, that is 2 only. Let's move on to the explanation. A non-banking financial company, which is also known as a shadow bank, it is a company which is registered under the Companies Act of 1956, and it is engaged in the business of loans and advances. It does not accept demand deposits. And acquisition of shares, stocks, bonds, debentures, securities which is issued by the Government of India, or other marketable securities of similar nature. So, it does not include any institution whose principal business is that of agricultural activity, industrial activity, purchase or sale of any sort of goods, or providing any services of sale and sale, purchase and construction of immovable property. So these are the sectors where NBFCs don't bother about. So features of NBFCs, if we talk about, these cannot accept demand deposits. So that is why NBFCs do not form a part of the payment and settlement system and does not issue checks drawn on itself. So deposit insurance facility, which is provided in the banks of Deposit Insurance and Credit Guarantee Corporation, it is not available to the depositors of NBFCs. Now let's move on to the next question, which says, with reference to Malayan giant squirrel, consider the following statements. It is listed as a near threatened species in the IUCN Red List. Second, slash and burn jhum cultivation in many areas of the Northeast contribute to destruction of its habitat. Which of the statements given above is or are correct? A1 only, B2 only, C both 1 and 2, D neither 1 nor 2. The correct answer for this question is C, both 1 and 2. Let's move on to the explanation. Now, the Zoological Survey of India, in a first of its kind study, has said that the numbers of the Malayan giant squirrel could decline by 90% by 2050, and it is one of the world's largest squirrel species that has dark upper body, pale underbody and a long and bushy tail. So unlike the nocturnal flying squirrel, that means who are active in the night, the giant squirrels are diurnal in nature. They are active in the daytime. They are arboreal. Arboreal means they live on trees and herbivores like the flying squirrel. If we talk about the conservation status, their IUCN Red List is near threatened. That is why. And in sites, it is in Appendix 2 and Wildlife Protection Act. Under it, it is in the Schedule 1. If we talk about the threats to its existence, it's deforestation, fragmentation of forests, crop cultivation and even over-harvesting of food. And illegal trade is also there in wildlife and hunting for consumption. And slash and burn jhum cultivation. It's an agricultural practice. Let's move on to the practice question for the next segment, which says, which of the following is our objectives of monetary policy? First, to stabilize the business cycle. Second, to provide reasonable price stability. Third, to provide faster economic growth. Fourth, exchange rate stability. Now you have to select the correct answer using code given below. A1 and 2 only, B2 and 3 only, C1, 3 and 4 only, or D1, 2, 3 and 4. So I hope you'll be able to answer it correctly in the comment segment. Thank you so much for watching. That's it for today. Tomorrow I'm going to turn up again. Stay updated.